In the fourth series of the European Championship, England met West Germany in a quarter-final at Wembley Stadium. 32 teams in 8 groups of 4 had set out upon the journey. On the 29th of April 1972, Germany, on her first visit to London since that 1966 World Cup defeat, went a goal ahead. In the second half, England clawed her way back and appeared quietly confident. But to leave England empty-handed again was not part of the German agenda. A penetrative run into the English penalty area, a rash challenge, and Günter Netzer, the new rising star of German football, made it 2-1 from the spot. Then Gerd Müller, a man born to score, added his unmistakable stamp, while all eyes fell upon Günter Netzer, the player who, 2 months later, would fashion Germany's first championship victory. 32 nations had entered the 1970-72 European Championship, and the preliminary rounds were played from within 8 groups. The quarterfinals, in which West Germany had eliminated England, were still played on a home-and-away knockout basis. The semi-finals and the final were hosted by Belgium, and it was Belgium who faced West Germany in a one-sided semi-final in Antwerp. Beckenbauer and Müller continued their double act of push and run. Haired midfield orchestrator possessed that uncanny knack of finding space and keeping space, while knowing exactly the right ball to play. Gerd Müller had found a new foil to feed his goal-hungry appetite.
Netzer was quite a character. He played well when not covered. But when Netzer had other players restricting his movements, he was not such a strong player. In such a situation, Oberath was the better player of the tournament. But Günter Netzer was good at taking free kicks, corners, and was an outstanding player when not covered. It was the cross-play between Beckenbauer and midfielder Netzer. There was a book called When Netzer Came from the Deep. I mean the depth of the pitch, where he worked with his long balls and sent players forward by the dozen on the attack. You could hear the spectators, ah, and ooh, in the stands. This was special. This was an attraction to see the team in those days.
Comfort and a spur, because it heralded a European Championship display from Netzer, Beckenbauer, Müller and the rest of the team, which would dazzle even the most ardent of German detractors. But the strong-willed Netzer appeared a rather solitary figure. An outsider from Mönchengladbach, amongst the polished Bayern Munich connection, was an irrelevance to the Soviet bench, who demanded greater effort. In the second half, Netzer controlled the proceedings like a sergeant major striding his parade ground. One-sided final since the conception of the competition. West Germany now had the players, the style, and the method to become worthy world champions. This was 1972. The World Cup was to be played in Germany in 2 years' time. When Franz Beckenbauer lifted the Henri Delaunay Cup, the German crowd were delirious. Brussels belonged to them. They had watched their team sweep aside all before them, their banners and their chants an expression of their devotion. Yet when the cup was passed around, one man called Netzer seemed reluctant, even embarrassed, to join the celebrations.